Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at how to create a simple custom icon for folders or files. So I'm going to show you how to create a custom folder icon for anything in the Finder. Now say I've got in my Documents folder, I have all these folders here and I want to make this one stand out a little bit. I can do that by customizing the icon here so it's not the same as these other folders. So I'm going to go to File and Get Info with that folder selected. And now it brings up information about it. And I can click on the icon here. And notice how now it shows that it's selected when I do that. One of the things I can do now that I've selected it is I could copy it. Now I wanted to do this simply, not using any extra software that you need to download or anything else. So I'm going to use Preview, which is built in. Now when I run Preview, I'm going to be able to then go to File, New from Clipboard. And I will get a new document created that has what I've copied. What I've copied is an icon. So an icon has different sizes. You can see here on the left all the different sizes represented. Now I can customize this icon by changing each one of these, but that's a pain to change every single one of these different pieces of this icon here. So instead I'm going to just simplify things. I'm going to leave this selected. Notice the first part of the icon is selected. And I'm going to do a copy again. Then I'm going to do New from Clipboard again. And this time instead of an icon being copied and put into a new document, just this image, the first part of the icon is. So now I've got the second document that's just a regular image. This is the one I'm going to edit. I'm going to edit it by going to Tools here and then just typing some text. So I'm going to hit the Text tool here. I'm going to type just the letter A. I'm going to adjust the size of it. I can make it different sizes if I want. I'm going to keep it here at something pretty big so it's large compared to the size of this folder. And I can move it around and adjust it and things like that. Now I want to put this back into the icon. So I can do several things. I can save it out and it will save it as an image file. And I could use that image file. But it's even easier if I were to just use the selection tool here. Do Command A for select all. And then do Command C for copy. Now I've copied this image into the buffer. Now I can hide preview and go back to the info window here for my folder. So make sure that the folder is selected and I'm going to paste. And there you go, I've pasted it in. Now the cool thing about pasting a graphic in as opposed to an icon file is it automatically interprets that single graphic is all the different sizes. So if I look here at the smaller size for the icon, I can see the letter A is there as well. So now I've successfully changed that folder. Now there's all sorts of different things I can do. If I go back to preview, I could add more characters here. I can do all sorts of things like, for instance, adjust the colors. So I can adjust the color of this entire graphic and change it to something else. So I have all sorts of weird things that I can do. Tinting, the folder color, that kind of thing. Lots of things you can do here without having to go into another graphics program. Of course, if you do have something like Photoshop or Acorn or Pixelmator or something like that, you can create all sorts of things. You can just start from scratch and completely create a completely new square image and then use that as the folder icon rather than doing this simple method of just quickly creating it. Once you get this technique down, though, it's really easy to quickly create something. Matter of fact, I can go in to this folder graphic here, and I still have this letter here as a separate piece on top. So I can change that to something else, and now I can select all, copy, and then paste that as another folder image in the Finder. So you can really quickly go and do something. And I could do other things. I can draw on that. I can use, say, an emoji icon on that. All sorts of different things. And then paste it here in the info window. If I wanted to clear that out and go back to the default, I can select and hit the delete key on my keyboard. And you can see it just goes back to the default here. So it's very easy to clear these and kind of experiment and see what you want to do to create new icons for things. And also note that you can do these for files as well as folders. So I select that file there and I can do the same thing here with the file. So if I had a bunch of text files, I can make one stand out by copying this and pasting it into preview and then editing it and pasting it back in. So a lot of cool stuff you can do just using the Finder and the Preview app to customize your icons.